think about it for a moment. That when we saw the focus on, he's talking about like the white part. He's trying to say the white part has a lot to do with it too, or the white part has something. You know, we never even denied that there are some faithful, you know, brothers and sisters of other so-called colors or other nationalities. We never denied that, right?
Yeah.
But in the vid,
I was wondering.
I was wondering what you were talking about too.
I was wondering, I was wondering what he was saying when he said we had four fathers. He's like, we never said we came from the black one. He said our father had four wives, and I was like, which one of his fathers?
What he's trying to do is play on Jacob. On Jacob, Jacob had two wives: his sisters Leah and Rachel, and Bilhah and Zilla and Zilla, Zilla. I think Bilhah and Zilpah. Thank you. You could have tied a name. Yeah, so he's trying to play on that to say that, you know, this is part one. They're trying to find reasons for, well, why the root is black, and then they are maybe Ashkenazi or coming out of Europe, instead of admitting that they basically, you know, were converts to the faith.
Right.
Argument, like perhaps one of the concubines was this or that or the next thing, and it's just some useless argument, basically. But what it is really, you know, it's the Holy Spirit told me, it's not what he's saying on the surface. It's not what a lot of, you know, it's when somebody is like critiquing you or whatnot, and it's not what you did, and you can't figure it out. It's almost like this temptation or this, it's like a trick mode. It's like man was created very good, and then he gets an offer of good and evil. And he doesn't figure out it's a trick. Why would I exchange my very good for your good and evil? You know what I mean? You know, why would I exchange something better? But it's a trick. It's like what the devil trying to do with Yeshua. Adonino exposed that right there. He said, if you cast yourself down, you know, from this pinnacle, then you know what is written in David or written in the Psalms, that he shall bear you in their wings and your foot won't dash against a stone. And Christ rebuked him. Why? Because what he was saying is commit suicide and God will save you. Can you imagine how many people probably did commit suicide thinking God was going to save them?
Right, exactly. That, and it has happened.
it was almost like,
know?
It's like that in that issue of High Times, the one that talk about the Bob Marley conspiracy about the the Nazi scientists. In the same article, they had somewhere in Jamaica, they had a bingy, and some brethren or some Rasta man basically that they said was mentally disturbed or this or that. That was mentally disturbed or whatnot like that. He basically sat down in the fire, and oh my goodness! No, we were just scrolling on the internet, and we're seeing these Ethiopians running around with all these white Jesus, washed out white Jesus pictures.
Yeah.
I mean, this picture here looked like just a whole bunch of little children. It's like my goodness! Oh wow! My goodness! I have no goodness.
I do have one point, and this is just because, you know, the scripture says a lie lasts for a moment, but the truth is everlasting, right? So on the internet, the Diary of a Hollywood Street King, has anyone seen that?
No.
Diary of a Hollywood Street King, it's a big article that says something like, a lying lion. It's like calling that new dogging his new Rastafarian religion. Anyway, the lying exposed. So I just wanted to say, you know.
Oh, yeah. I heard something. Yeah, I did see a vid.
Lying exposed.
Mm.
So praise Jah for the Holy Spirit and truth, the Spirit of truth. So.
Amen. You know what we need to do?
Definitely.
We need to get some posters.
The world is seeing, and this is a worldly man who's saying he is not. it is a world a worldly man testifying that this is not Rastafarianism, and he mentioned Haile Selassie. So big up, you know, this movement.
Wow, big up.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So yeah, so that's on the
it's on which platform? It's called The Diary of a Hollywood Street King.
Oh, okay, Diary of a Hollywood Street King. All right. Yeah, definitely.
Snoop Dogging and all this other wonderful slander.
Yeah, it's like tailgating in a sense.
Yes, I.
It's almost like, you know, you could tailgate. You know that strategy. Like somebody tailgating and they could push you off the road like that. But you think they're following you.
But you know, I'm just, you know, the information is out there. We read the article, so brethren, you know, feel free to read the article and, you know, see what's up. But it is out there exposing, and there's some there's information about Haile Selassie and how he is definitely not. He's just doing it just for, you know,
financial or
worldly
just
purposes. Well, you know, the truth is coming. It's out. You understand? So, but even in good, even in these bad, as in publicity, and in bad, good comes out for the kingdom, because it still it gives us an opportunity.
No weapon formed against I and I shall fall, but every tongue that shall rise up in a judgment, thou shall condemn. And this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and my righteousness and the righteousness of thee. Yeah. That's so true right there. But yes, now I just saw that picture while I was talking. I just saw, because there's a screen here and the click and seeing different. I saw a picture of some three children with three Roman Renaissance Jesus, angel, and some Lucrezia and Rodrigo, you know, who they think is Jesus and the baby and stuff like that, you know, Jesus. Jesus had sex with his sister and they had a bastard child, Rodrigo. And then the Medici, they paid for these paintings to be created. And then these paintings were given to Rome, and Rome said, hey, these people are so stupid. We'll tell them this is Jesus and everybody. And that's how we got the pictures and stuff like that. And, you know, the interesting thing is they will tell you themselves in their documentation, but once people begin to be naive, it's almost like it's only grace that really saves them. You know what I mean? It's only if the Almighty is so grateful. Because you can show them a mountain of books. You can show them videos, websites sometimes, and it's like, how come you're not getting this? Because I think grace. It's really grace, and some people really maybe can't receive that grace. Because why does anybody want to come to the light? Because if they come to the light, their dirty deeds will be exposed.
Yeah.
You see, but then they had pleasure in unrighteousness. So some folks out there, you might be like, I want to show you the truth, and you wonder why they ain't getting it. Because they take pleasure in the way they'll be living. You'd be like, I want better for you. That's because you wanty-wanty. Yummy, yummy, licky-licky. You understand? You want this for them, but they do not want it for themselves. They want to keep living in sin. You know what I mean? They want to keep living in an effed-up world. You're like, well, we want to make people, and like I said, it's not make-believe. It's preach the word and see who it resonates with. It's like when Christ says, and you go into a house, and you salute the house. Yes, and if there's a son of peace there, then abide there. But if there's not a son of peace there, then your peace, you draw your shalom to yourself, and you get out of there and dust off your feet and tell them it's better for Sodom and Gomorrah, you understand, than for you. You know, you speak that word. Even if you're not telling them, you don't have to say, hey, come on, I got something to tell you. No, you speak the word. Why? Because Yeshua says speak the word. That means that's sealed up. And say it's about obedience. Something's about, you know, we like to, well, how's that going to work out? It's a bug. We live in a world that we be doing a lot of stuff, sending, you know, doing a lot of stuff in this world, and they never tell us how it's going to work out. You know what I mean? You know, we never, almost like, you know, we have to abide by these earthly laws, and they don't explain even half of it. I mean, you know how the tax code works? You pay taxes. You know how the tax code works? I mean, the one really know about how these things, and yet Jah will so mercifully explain detail by detail, word by word. So it's not about make-believe. It's not about making no one believe. You know what I mean? And it's not, people might say, oh, you're cold. Don't you want to, listen, I can't go to the cross for nobody. Oh, yeah, I see it right here. Snoop Dogging his new Rastafarian religion.
No, it's a second one. There's a second one underneath it, the lying.
Oh, yeah, but yeah, I'm looking at the graphics. Yeah, Snoop Dogging is a lying lion exposed. Okay, yeah, I'll definitely check that out. Okay, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, well, you know, they're trying to find ways, you know. You have the strategy. Oh, but you got to think this, that as there is a true God in this world, you understand, and he manifests in Rastafari, and it's manifested through Rastafari, this salvation, then they would have to try to find ways in, especially seeing the time is getting, you know what I mean,
mm-hmm.
It's getting more.
Well, it's already 12:59:30, 45, maybe.
Yeah. But it almost remind me of the sons of Scythia. You remember the vagabond Jews? You know, the vagabond Jews and stuff like that. Perhaps this might be an opportunity for a lot of ones to really come to the truth. Maybe there has to be some demonstration. You know what I mean? Who knows what all of this will basically lead to. You know what? They plan a plan. You know what I'm saying? But Jah is the best of planners. So they're planning what they're planning. But you know what I mean? Jah protect his, you know, his majesty protect his divine majesty, protect his divine children. Yehovah's. But like what I was trying to say with it is like, on a certain level, so what? You know, on a certain level. Maybe he will come. Maybe he won't. But that's not what we're... Is he studying Torah with us? You know what I mean? Is he seeking to be discipled? Or he already is? I already showed y'all already that there's this Church of Satan out there in the Cali, in the Cali area. So, you know, I heard that they had moved to Ethiopia. Yeah, I heard they moved to Ethiopia.
I was reading about some of that.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, but you know, even
no,
that.
Probably that's not. You know, it's the same as the first century. This is how.
Let me give you a little hint. Leviathan is destroyed in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a verse. You know the verse that says, and the people of the wilderness, the people of, I think it's Psalm 70, was it 74 or is it 75, where it says, it translates in the King James, the people of the wilderness. It says the people of the wilderness shall lick the dust or something like that. But when you read it, that verse, that psalm in the Amharic, it actually talks about how Leviathan gets cut up. In Leviathan gets cut up in Ethiopia, but in the translation, they suppress that. So every time I think about all their strategies against Ethiopia and Africa, I just kind of like, yeah, come on, bring Africa in. Yeah, go ahead, bring Africa in.
We've recently been studying the second Esdras, and that's pretty insightful with back in the chapter 15 and chapter 16, it talks about Asia. I mean, it's in the Apocrypha. That starts to get really clear, and it's like rap. And Mandela and I talked about it, or reasoned over it. It was, you know, something to consider cross-referencing.
You should have recorded it and then shared it with the rest of us so we can listen to it while we drive
it.
It was a spontaneous.
It was a spontaneous.
It was Fontanega, right?
Yes, Fontanega. Yes, right. But we're going to share it.
No, but here's the verse. Here's the verse. I just want you to get this verse. 74 and 14. Thou breakest the heads of Leviathan in pieces and gave him to be meat or food to the people inhabiting the wilderness. The wilderness there is Ethiopia. So it would really read, thou breakest the heads of Leviathan in pieces and gave him to be food to the people inhabiting Ethiopia. So that's Psalm 74 and 14. So that's why maybe sometime when I'll be talking about AFRICOM, I'll be like, yeah, go ahead, Obama, now's your time. Go forward. Move forward. In other words, let's conclude this mess right here. Bring all your arms
and
down
it
here.
It looks like we can
go. Wrap this movie up. Let's see the credits. Let's get it going.
For real, because there's
it
no
like
weapon that's falling,
close, you know.
You know, there's no weapon that's falling against.
Though they're getting close.
Yes, I. That's
you know,
why they even get stronger. What is that verse, Wendim, that says, the violent try to take the kingdom and they take it by force? Anyone can know which one I'm talking
that's
to.
Matthew, that's
no,
chapter.
Talking about.
That's Matthew
yes,
chapter 11, where it's talking about John the Baptist's bankruptcy. We're
yes,
talking about how John. That the
it's
kingdom
of
love of bankruptcy.
Yeah.
Suffer
yeah,
violence. The stock market crash.
Yeah.
Yes, and Brethren Alonzo and I were speaking on that too. Like, you know, what does that, like, decipher it?
You have to be aggressive about, and they're not aggressive against someone or against some person. But aggressive for the things of Jah and for the things of his kingdom once
yes,
you are intelligent to what's in his kingdom. Because, honestly, a lot of us are not really fully intelligent as we should be to what's in his kingdom. I thought I was until I really even started the regular Torah portion. I'm like, wow. I said, I didn't really get that before. You know what I mean? I'm like, that's interesting. I got to take a note of that. You know what I mean?
Brother Ras Iadonis, aren't we supposed to hate evil?
But first we're supposed to learn what evil is.
Right.
In other words, learn what our Father considers evil. Because, see, a lot of times people talk about evil, we talk about it from a subjective point of view, which is a self-righteous
right.
point. I'm so right, the other person's so wrong.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And therefore, you took my ice cream, you evil, you the devil. I mean, I cannot even mention how many times I've called people brethren and sister and sometimes the devil. You know what I'm saying? You know, like just because you disagree with me, I call you the devil. You know what I mean?
Anything that is not in line with Scripture or in line with God's word, with Yah's word, or anything that doesn't represent the kingdom, you know, in that sense.
I get you
like,
in a gentle
like
sense. Go ahead, bro. Greeting.
Hello?
No, that's I heard somebody say something.
Oh, yeah, I was saying like blasphemy. Like, you know, I remember hearing a cat that was, you know, I remember him, he was on the net and he was, you know, posting up this saying. He kept saying Jah's name, right? But he kept, you know, you just hear the mockery, you know, from the guy.
Oh,
like, you know,
because
he didn't know what he was doing.
Yeah, but those are little fish to fry. Those are little distractions. It's almost like a professional fighter in a fight that's staring his enemy eye to eye, and there's people around, and people are talking stuff on the side. A professional is never going to take his eye off the enemy. Never. You're going to have to hit him
right.
in order for him to take his eye off of the enemy. So some of these things are a little distraction, a little like, because they know that we still are almost like little children on a certain level that we easily can get offended. So they'll say even the most outrageous things against His Majesty. They want us to get on some mission. Because you remember that the demonic entities that a lot of these people are under, Because remember, the devil has
right.
taken people captive to do his own will. You understand? Some people have generational things that they have to still break. You understand? Confront and break. You understand? That these sort of beings, they feed off of your pain. You know, like almost like if it was like little kids, how some of us, and maybe I was also a bad kid like this, if we knew like you couldn't take a joke, we'll keep ranking on you all day long. And when you start laughing at the joke and ranking back, then you become one of us. Then we stop talking about you and you can hang out with us. In a sense of, I'm trying to explain the principle that if we allow these, and I've seen this going on like on a lot of sidebar issues to get us to go off on a little sidebar issue. Like, say we're getting ready for repatriation. They want us to, you know, talk about what's happening in the local school district. Why,
right.
if we're working towards repatriation, why does it concern us what is happening in the, you know what I'm saying? So,
yes,
and that's what we learn spiritual, in that sense, kind of discipline on a certain level. So where it says the kingdom of heaven suffer violence and the violent take it by force, a better translation would be the kingdom of heaven suffers pushiness. And the pushy, you understand, they enter in by pushing. They push their way in. You know why they call it Babylon? Because Babel means the gate of God. But then Babel means confusion. There's two close Hebrew words. It's kind of a little joke, especially if ones don't know Hebrew. The Jews usually say that one who just reads the Bible is a blockhead. In other words, if you don't study the Bible, you're a blockhead.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because the word Babel mean confusion, and Bab El mean the gate of God in the Hebrew. And I wondered why this was for so long, like why these words are so close, and what's the, you know, is there any more that it means? One day the Holy Spirit just illuminated me and said, don't you recognize, and I think I was looking at a picture of the Imperial Palace, like all the people that would come during the time of His Majesty's visible visitation on the throne, that people would come to the palace for favors or for appointment or whatever, right? That there was always a lot of people, right? That you always notice outside of God's gate, there would be a confusion. Because everybody is trying to get in. You
yes,
understand? So you have this two ways of looking at the gate of God. There is a confusion. And because of not just I and I work, but all of us in our various different ways of just living and living for the truth of Rastafari, the King of Kings and His Christ, more and more ones are beginning to see like, oh, chan, this Rastafari thing is not the Amon joke that we try to have the Cosby's, you know,
right.
Kind of stereotype it, that is really deeper than that. So, of course, we're getting like the dragnet. You know, we're getting the Snoop lion, dog lion, dog is
yeah,
lame,
yeah.
dog lion. I don't know, dog lane or lame dog, lame dog lion. I don't know what it really is. Maybe
I'm wondering
he might
about
have a,
that, like.
Yeah, maybe he might have a eureka. But you know what? Why does it even waste our time? He is not on our path. Leave him on
exactly.
the wayside. Because remember the sower and the seed? Remember the sower and the seed? You understand? Some seed fall by the wayside. Some seed fall
exactly.
on the stony ground. Some of them fall on the thorny ground, right? But only the few on the good ground. And they're the only ones that produce. Some produce 30%. Some produce 60%. Some produce 100%. What does that teach us? Listen, brothers and sisters, even if you only find yourself be doing 30% as much as the front runner brother or sister out there, hey, 30% is better than 0%. You know what I mean? 30% is better than wayside eaten up by bird percent. 30% and 60% is better than stony ground, no root in yourself percent. You
okay.
understand? You know, 30 or 60% is better than getting the word of God choked because you're too caught up on materialism, trying to meet the world standards, and you don't recognize you're not humble to God's standards right here. You're trying to impress the world standards because you forgot that you walk in through this gate right here, and that gate is Christ. So some of that stuff you're going to have to check. You know what I'm saying? You know, like when you go to a foreign country, they're like, do you have anything to declare? Yeah, I got to declare all my sins. You understand? I got to clear all that right now, and I want to leave that right here. You know what I'm saying? So the distractions there, it's like I was looking at the YouTubes, not the YouTube, the Facebook. I saw some kind of crazy stuff. I'm like, oh, my goodness. I mean, from some brothers and sisters who otherwise, you know, who otherwise I would reason with. You know, and so forth and so on. You know what I mean? But, you know, sometimes I don't even worry about that. If I don't want to look at it, you keep on. But sometimes we get stuck on it. We have to recognize that there are dimensional entities that feed off of our discomfort. They feed off of our depression. They feed off of this. And we are given, we say, oh, Ras Iadonis, you don't understand. No, you don't overstand, you understand, this word of the kingdom. Because if you did, you would say, oh, wow, that's so true. And you would do what you have to do and be laughing at these demons. You ain't getting on my energy. I ain't going to feel stressed. Listen, you don't lay a hand on me, I'm going to keep laughing. You lay a hand on me, I'm going to say, in Yeshua's name, I'm going to break your arm.
Yeah.
Because, oh, but we're supposed to be about peace and love. Can you find that verse for me? Can you find the peace and love verse? I've been looking for it for a while. Show me. We are talking about peace and love. You know, come on. Like as Matt said, enough illusions, illusions. Don't subvert people with words, especially words misquoted or words that's not even referring to, you know, what's here in I covenant. I mean, cause it's serious like that. It's really, I mean, to show you this, those people will be doing their satanistic things. Notice this. When it's the Sabbath, the same time that we're supposed to be honoring and remembering the Sabbath to keep it set apart from the other 6 days of the week, the people who will be doing the occult things, the black Sabbath, the whatever they, white, black, whatever color, gray Sabbath, you know what they be doing? They faithfully follow their God, what they call him, Satan or Lucifer or Johnny Carson. You know, no insult to Johnny Carson, but, you know, it wasn't one of my favorites. But what I'm trying to say is that they faithfully, if Satan says to them or their devils say, we want a sacrifice, right? They go out there and get the sacrifice. If their devils say, well, you're going to have a black warlock, wizard, witchcraft, magic, dance, song and dance, Disney, it's going to be aired on PBS. You understand? And you need to do it at this time, on this day, and make sure the sun, the moon, and the stars are lined up. They're going to faithfully do that. Why do you think they're doing that?
Right.
They are doing it to channel the metaphysical, hyperdimensional beings that they believe are gods or super dudes and dudettes or ascended masters. And then when we're supposed to be doing what the Father says, we wonder why we're so weak. We wonder why our movement's so messed up, because we think, oh, I could do it any way I want to do it because, you know, it's all about it with my mouth. I am Lord. No, 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 no. That's like that song that said, with our mouths, we are lords. Who are lords over us? You understand? Nah. It's when his word is in our mouth. And when that word that's in our mouth is first and foremostly rooted and grounded with Christ reigning in our heart. But what I'm trying to show is that the people who do the occult things, they do these rituals at certain times and certain seasons when the moon and the stars and the other things are aligned, so forth and so on. They're not just doing this because it's dressed up, because it's fun, but because they are real hyper-dimensional beings that we call demonic entities or evil spirits that they are channeling and helping to back them up with whatever evilest things they are doing in the earth. Now, we think, like some people say, well, I don't really have to read the Bible because Jah is in my heart. You know what I mean? And Jah is in my... All right, you keep playing yourself. You better... you better not even meet those baby demons. They'll tear you a new one. I mean, there's some serious things. If you ever was in a situation where you had to speak to people who were under some, I mean, I don't want to go into one particular thing. One person, I don't know. We don't know what's happened to them since. But, you know, when you really see some brothers and sisters who fall away, as it were, and get caught up back out there in the world, man, and you can tell that, I mean, it's, man, that's why sometimes I would have wished or hoped I had known now what I know now then. I mean, I know sometimes I even say my own prayers, forgive me, Father, and I hear him say it's not your fault on that one, you know, or on this one or that one, you know, but sometimes you don't know sometimes at the time to give that right answer. And that's what really, I think that's what helps me in my, went to the kingdom of heaven, suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. Why be one of the violent that take it by force? Not violent in the sense of violent in the world violent, but one who is aggressive for the things of the kingdom. You know what I'm saying?
I got an example for Finhas when he got stabbed up.
Yes, sir.
You know, he had he brought the woman into the camp and they were trying to do the thing. I forgot which portion it was.
When Phineas had struck through him with the javelin.
Yes,
that he was, because they already were under a curse, a plague. People were dying, babies, women, men, children. They were under a plague, and now they're trying to reverse the curse. And this, and you know what it says in Phineas? It's actually called Phineas, the portion Phineas. Or really, maybe the portion before that, the one before that. It said that another dude brought a woman. While they were at the tabernacle, while everybody was at the tabernacle praying, one is going to get their groove on, getting their nasty, nasty on. When it's that very, it's 40 and 41 portion, Torah portion. And someone brought a woman to this other man, almost like somebody playing the pimp, you know, because there's one man who brought the woman to another one, and then they go off to the tent to do the nasty while people are praying for intercession that the curse, that Jah would forgive them. And Phineas looked around, you know, like, you know, when you see some people do, you know, we're like in a crowd and somebody's doing, and you say, where are they going? That's what they, you know, and Phineas kind of saw it and he reacted and he was zealous. You understand? Now, that doesn't mean that that's the way we always in the new covenant must go about it. But we're talking about old covenant there. Now, the new covenant, it might be so much as speaking that rhema word, just speaking, exposing with your word, and don't fear or care what people are going to say about it. You know what I'm saying? I know, like, even when I first went on the YouTubes, man, there was some hard-ass people saying, excuse my language if it offends any, but there was some hard donkeys, you understand, that were, you know, that was saying all sort of things. Oh, Rasta this, and who do you think you are, and you know what I mean? And that was a test for me right there. That's why I said in one video, some of you might recall, I understand why some people don't want to post, because y'all afraid when you see these nasty commenters, but actually that was like a test, you understand, a test for good. Fine, because after a while when you get through it, because what tests you is, like, if you're still in your ego, it's going to hurt you a whole lot. If you're an ego person, it's going to hurt you a lot. And it did hurt me a little bit at first. You know what I'm saying? Because I had to get beyond ego. I'm like, wait, what are they saying? They're talking about how I look. They're talking about this. They're talking about that. But what am I talking about? And why am I talking about? You know, it helped you clear, you know, get your, you know, it helps you clear your conscience. It helped you clear exactly what you really are doing. So you're willing to suffer a little bit of people talking nonsense. Like, if you look at some of the comments on, I mean, there's a lot of comments, because we're still trying to download the, you know, as many of the videos, as many of the 1,732 videos that we have out there. And occasionally, in downloading some of them, just backing them up, I came across a couple of comments. And now when I read it, it's kind of like, for example, I was telling this to sister, I think it was the other day I was speaking to Sister Abisa. Is Abisa on the line?
Yes, sir.
I was speaking to Sister Abisa, and I was saying that I would look up Ethiopian World Net. Right? You can just look up Ethiopian World Net, put it in your Google browser, and then you could look under the videos. I think it would come up, and there was somebody who did a video, these two. And you said it right, sis. You said these two punks. I haven't heard that used in a long time, these two punks. Because that's how we call them, BK, these two punks, right, who did some video, Ethiopian World Net and his Rasta Coons. When I first saw I wanted to get all in that. You know what I mean? I wanted to, but then I just laughed. I said, and when the sister said these two, they look like two punks, I just had to laugh. I haven't heard that in a long time. You know, these two punks. And you know what? I was going to listen to the video and hear what their point is. And the Spirit always said, listen, if you want to respond to that, respond to them from Paul. You remember what happened to Paul? Paul was getting ridiculed by his own Jewish brothers because he's no longer going along with that Pharisee shitism. You know, he's been going off the Pharisee shitism. You know what I'm saying? He already now recognized he's not blind anymore. And remember, that's why they were trying to kill Paul. Remember, it was his own people where he says, my own people of my own skin. It was my own black people that was trying to kill me is what Paul is saying. Now I go to Rome and 3,000 accept the faith, a mixed multitude. Some of them are Roman, European, and some of them are Hebrew, Israelite, and other nationalities. You understand? But he did not get one convert. You understand? One from his old gang of folks. And then I said, wow, I was down with the Hebrews. I mean, out here in Brooklyn, we stand up on the street. We call you out. We call you out like nothing. You understand? We call you punk because we figure we have numbers and everything. But, you know, I was down with that. So I already know the doctrine in and out, forward, backwards, so forth and so on. But and I say that like that because the real height was Rastafari. That was the real height. You understand? Learn about Ethiopia, learning about our language. Most of these Hebrew Israelites have to rely on Masoretic Jewish scriptures, which basically, how can I say, is the Babylonian Talmud. You know, the Masorah means tradition. Christ said, your tradition has made void or vain the word of God. You know what I'm saying? So you know, I was looking at that vid, and first there was a little temptation to get upset. I was like, who's this kind of Ethiopian World Man, Rasta Coons? And this person said, what kind of self-respecting black people going to call other proud black men and woman and child coons? I said, these are some punks right here. And I said, you know what? I pass, God. I pass. In other words, I pass on even dealing with that. I don't even deal with that. You know, that's some little nonsense. But you see, when we still are caught up in ego, we can't let it go. Because, like, you talking about me? But a lot of times that could be a trap, too, if you think about it in other ways, too. I mean, don't know how that kind of go. You know, like somebody who has a quick temper, you can set them up easily. So you have to really listen to the Spirit and say, you know what? Choose your battles. I heard someone say this, a king or a real queen never fights where there's no victory of any spoil. Why are you going to fight? Why am I going to mobilize my army if I'm a real king and I have an army and we ain't going to get nothing from this but satisfy my own ego? You understand? Even my troops will grow up and say, listen, I love the king, but he be going some silly battles. You know what I mean? We be putting out all of this. We gonna get nothing from it. He's battling because somebody looked at him wrong. You know what I mean? We had to leave our wives and our families and risk our lives because somebody looked at him wrong. You know what? I'm leaving this kingdom. No, for real. So you really have to choose. You know, you have to really choose. You know what I'm saying? Choose what the Father has put before us. And it does take a moment. I'm not going to say it's overnight. Anybody that tells you it's overnight, that's like these fly-by-night churches, these counterfeit. What was my new saying that I'm going to call them? Counterfeit Christian trolls. You know, like the counterfeit Christian trolls you see on the, you know, like one tried to hit up a vid and say, oh, there's not three Christ, there's only one Christ. I said, I was reading it, I said, this person's retarded. I said, I'm not going to answer this. Ignore them. You know, because when you answer them, then they feel like, yes, see, I knew I had a point. You understand? But when you don't answer them, then the demons they're under have to smack them up. Like, you stupid. How come you couldn't get that Rastafarian to turn away from Haile Selassie to answer your monkey ass? You know what I mean? For real. You know, and then you really start to recognize your spiritual strength. And we don't have to answer every kind of, even when he want to talk about his majesty, some of them. Well, for his majesty's sake, for father's sake, we might engage him. Well, next level, that's what we did. That's what we even stopped on some of the Hebrew Israelite stuff for a moment. Because really, it's a garbage argument. Most of these niggas don't want to stop receiving their welfare checks. They don't really want to come out. Because that's too much self-responsibility. Most of these project Jews, they want to talk about the white man on the weekend and then go work for him the next 6 days a week. Then when we're talking about our own land in Africa and so forth and so on, they're going to call us coons. Come on, are they serious now? I was really thinking and saying, you know what, if these people were in my territory, I would sell them into slavery. I know that might bother some of y'all, but think about it before you get too upset with me. You know, I would sell them into slavery. What good they're gonna be in our land? See, it's fun that they're in Babylon. They are Obama's problem. They're not, you know, they're Obama's. That's Obama's problem. It's not our problem. Like, we think we have to bring every crazy, lazy, silly nigga to Africa with us. Can you imagine? Why don't you bring them in your house? Why don't you have them in your house? You understand? They want might sleep with your husband or sleep with your wife. How you like it then? You want to help them out?
Iadonis?
Hello?
Yes. Did the I?
Yes,
he might have cut out.
Yeah,
he might have cut out.
He
cut out. That's why he was there. Good call, man.
I want to keep on a point about the the demonic entities feeding off of us. You know, another thing is you can think of is in the Matrix movie, you know. It's the same thing. It's the same idea, yeah, with the humans. You know, they use the humans, you know, in another way, but they still
humans are
being used.
And they would go into them
to feed that whole world. System.
Yeah, and you know, there's some theories of thought, some philosophies of thought that says those demons eat off of our emotions, anger, fear,